Hi, I'm attorney Julie Hauf. Today I wanted to talk a little bit about life care planners and what to do when there is a life care plan that's presented in your case that's not exactly a full life care plan, but what it really is trying to get into evidence the cost of future surgeries, future procedures, and future medical care that's related to the accident. First of all, as always with any expert, you want to go back and take a look and see if you can find other depositions or orders that have been entered related to cases that they've been in. Look for an Elkins list. Make sure you get your discovery out early, getting that expert witnesses Elkins list. You can see the other cases, depositions, trials that they've testified in. Then go do your homework and get copies of the depositions. There may be very well be helpful impeachment information in there. You might also come across orders, Joubert orders, motion striking the expert or limiting their testimony in some other regard. If you've got the right information in your deposition, you can walk them into making those same types of statements that might limit their ability to testify in your case as well. Most importantly, take a look at what they're relying upon. What are they basing their opinion on? If they are saying that XYZ surgery is going to be needed, make sure we know where that recommendation comes from, that it's from a physician that they spoke with, not someone that I see this usually in other cases like this, so here's what I expect is happening next. Make sure that recommendation is coming from a valid source of someone who on their own could come in and testify that these are the appropriate things that this particular plaintiff needs in the future as a result of this accident or this loss. Make sure also that the expert is using the right standard to decide whether or not things need to be happened in the future. Came across an order recently where an expert life care planner's opinion was struck as she was attempting to testify that here's all of the things that I think are more likely than not to occur in the future. Here in Florida, the proper standard is going to be what's reasonably certain to occur, not maybe, might need it, reasonably certain to occur. And if you're not sure that the expert knows and understands what that right standard is, come right out and ask. Ask if they think reasonably certain is similar to or the same as more likely than not. If they do say that for you, again, that may be additional grounds to come in and strike their testimony. If they're coming in, and of course they're the bulk of their opinion is going to be about the charges that might be incurred in the future and what the costs for the procedures, surgeries, other items that are recommended will be. Make sure you know where those charges are coming from. Look for the background, what data, what did they use to get up and come up with those costs to make sure that they are something that's appropriate. Now, if you see that there are also surgeries that have happened in the past in the file before they came in and take a look at the case, what did they do and go back and look at to make sure whether the charges from the current provider that have already occurred, were those charges reasonable? Are they just going to that doctor and saying, hey, and they're going to need this procedure in the future, what are you going to charge? There's a multitude of state and national databases, other places and sources, Medicare fee schedules that you can look at and see what other payers would pay for a procedure like that. So make sure you understand where their numbers come from. If they say they're basing their numbers on, well, here's what the surgeon told me it would cost, did they also go back and do an analysis on the surgeon's prior charges to make sure that those also were reasonable? As if, for example, those were not reasonable, then it would stand to reason that the charges for the future care would not be reasonable as well. Make sure also, finally, that the person that is putting together the recommendations has actually talked to, not just sent letters back and forth with or understood from opposing counsel, what the actual needs for their surgeries in the future would be. Have they just sent a form? Did they have a conversation? What is going on? How did they get that information? Is it a check the box? Did they ask someone to fill out a list? Make sure you confirm that you know where the recommendations came in. You want to make sure that this expert for future medical costs is not a conduit for inadmissible hearsay. You want to make sure that any recommendations that he or she is making as what something might cost in the future are recommendations that actually have come into evidence or are capable of coming into evidence from someone who is competent and qualified to testify as to that. Any other questions, you know where to find us. Thanks so much. Have a great day.